Hi, today we are going to see how to interface EEPROM with 8051 microcontroller. This can be done using I2C bus. I2C, it is nothing but IIC, Integrated Circuit. And EEPROM stands for Electrically Erasable Programmable Read-Only Memory. It is a non-volatile memory and it is not as speed as flash memory. Only one byte can be erased at a time, and we can erase the memory using UV radiation. I2C, it is a serial bus and it is used to synchronize a slow working or slowly performing peripheral devices with a fast working controller unit or microprocessor unit. I2C, it consists of two wires. One is SCL line and another one is SDA line. SCL is serial clock line and SDA is serial input line, or also called as serial data or address line. Now let us see how to interface 8051 with EEPROM using this I2C bus. This is 8051 microcontroller unit and this is EEPROM IC. We are using IC24C04. The I2C bus SCL line and SDA line is connected with the pin of EEPROM called SCL and SDA. In turn, with 8051, it is connected to the port number P2.6 and P2.7. These two are pull-up resistors and it is combinedly connected to the supply. This is the basic interfacing diagram. The microcontroller unit, it is going to control the EEPROM via this I2C bus, I2C, it will always access master and EEPROM will be always access the slave device. Now what we are going to perform with this EEPROM? Obviously we are going to write or read, or we may erase the data from EEPROM, right? So it must have some control word for doing the opposite things. This is the control word. This control word's MSB is always a start bit, and as we saw in RTC control word or command word, this 4 bits 1010, it is a standard one and it is followed by 3 address lines A2, A1, A0. This combinedly used to address the slave device. Here the slave device is EEPROM. EEPROM is slave device. So in this field we are going to mention the address of that EEPROM, followed by we are going to mention the operation, what we are going to perform, either read or write. Read now 1, write now 0. Followed by an acknowledgement bit. Yes, I acknowledge this is a control word. It must be performed in EEPROM. And this control word is given using I2C bus, the master. Now, after seeing this control word, we are going to see how this I2C master is going to initiate a start condition and going to finish the data transfer read or write process. Now we are going to see the start condition, whatever it may be, initializing, starting or stopping, whatever it may be, it must be initiated by the master. What is master here? The I2C bus is the master here. The start condition, these two lines SDA and SCL, in start condition both SDA and SCL will initially in logical 1. This is the duration of the start condition. In this start condition the SDA falls to logical 0 and SCL it will remain in 1. After this it will move to 0. This is the program where we are mentioning SDA, it is initially 1 and SCL is also initially 1. After some delay, SDA goes to 0. This is the start condition. This is the start condition provided by the bus master. Here the master is I squared C to the slave EE room. Similarly, we are going to see the stop condition. This stop condition is also initiated by the I squared C master. In start condition, initially SDA remains in 0 and SCL is in 0. This is the stop condition portion. At stop condition, this 0 will turn to 1, but here it will maintain in 1. This is the stop condition. See the program. SCL, it is initially 0. After a delay, SDA, it is also initially 0. Delay, SCL changes to 1. See, at starting of the stop condition, SCL changes to 1. After a delay, SDA is also changing to 1 in stop condition. This is the program for stop condition. Okay, now we are familiar with how to start and stop a transmission between EEPROM and 8051. Now let us see how to write something in EEPROM. So we are going to write something from 8051 microcontroller to EEPROM. This is governed by I2C bus. I2C is the master. It is going to initiate the start command. It is going to initiate the start command as well as it is going to finish the process. The write mode, it consists of 6 steps. Initially, in first step, the start command is going to generate from the master. Then it must mention, I am going to select a device for writing process. What device I am going to select here? Here I am going to select EEPROM. So I am going to mention the address with a write mode operation. Then I am going to mention the register address. In which register I am going to perform the write operation. Okay. Then followed by I am going to send the data. What data I am going to write in that particular register in EEPROM. The data I am going to send following. Then finally, if I want to send more number of datas, I want to write more number of datas into the register, following register, then I will send the datas continuously. Finally, the stop command will be generated by I2C bus. Now, how to perform read operation? So I am going to read. I means the 8051 microcontroller needs to read something from EEPROM. Obviously, the start command will be initiated by the master I2C. Then it is going to select the device. Which device? From which device I am going to read? EEPROM. So I am going to mention the address of the EEPROM with write mode. Okay. Then I am going to mention the register address. From which register I am going to read the data? That register address must be mentioned. And again, I am going to start a command. Here, why I am going to start a command? I am going to read, perform a read operation, not write. I am going to perform a read operation. Here we are using both read mode and write mode. Write mode is for selecting the EEPROM device. After selecting the EEPROM device and register address, again I am starting the command and I am going to read a data from the selected register address. Then after reading the data, I2C will obviously generate the stop command. This is how an interfacing between 8051 and EEPROM using I2C bus will works. Thank you.